Hello everyone, this is Reverend Dr. Rebecca Michael, and today I'm doing a continuation of Spiritual Warfare for my Theological Studies new playlist over at YouTube. And so today I would like to just start this particular series emphasizing Ephesians, the Spiritual Warfare chapter to do with armoring ourselves and how we're to proceed to deal with the spiritual warfare. And so that's in Ephesians 6, especially 10 to 18. And so just a quick overview of Ephesians, which is a good book to read to do with spiritual warfare. Going by the headings, we see that it starts introducing in chapter 1 the spiritual blessings we have in Christ, which is very important to know that we're a new creation once we're regenerated by the Holy Spirit, and there's just two kingdoms. And so we're all born into the kingdom of darkness by default, but at the age of accountability, when we repent of unbelief and we come to the Lord Jesus Christ in true repentance, He regenerates us because He came to save. And We have spiritual blessings in Christ. So Ephesians 1 tells us about that, to do with walking in the Spirit. And Ephesians 2, the chapter, is the new life with Christ in the household of God, explaining the new life of Christ and how God has ordained creation and how we're to proceed. And that's important knowledge to understanding spiritual warfare. And because it's a total socialization into the kingdom of God, and Jesus Christ is the King of the kingdom of God. And so we have to unlearn, which is the process of sanctification or repentance, old bad things that we may have learned from the kingdom of darkness, and relearn in the kingdom of God, the order of God in family and belief system, etc. And so then chapter 3 introduces us, the Ephesians church, to Paul the apostle to the Gentiles, and how we're strengthened through the Spirit. And chapter 4 emphasizes the unity of the Spirit, that we're one body, we're not to be fighting amongst ourselves. For example, it says in verse 4, there is one body and one Spirit, even as you're called, in one hope of your calling. One Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in all. And so what we see here is that we may have the Lord loves diversity. He never made anything the same. He doesn't repeat anything, but He loves unity, and that unity is the bond of love. Agape love, specifically in 1 Corinthians 13, I did another video on that just now, to do with the love chapter of the Bible. And so we put off the old life, continuing in chapter 4 of Ephesians, and we put on the new life. For example, in Ephesians 4:17, it says, "This I say therefore and testify in the Lord, that you henceforth walk not as the Gentiles walk, in the vanity of their mind, having their understanding darkened, being alienated from the life of God through the ignorance that's in them because of the blindness of their heart." And then it goes on. But we're to walk in newness of life, which is that which is in Christ Jesus. And so we need to be sanctified from within and from without in order to become overcomers and sanctified in the Holy Spirit once we're just justified, which is a miraculous work of God. And so then it, chapter 5 goes on to do with educating us about the works of light and darkness, because often we have these two confused when we come to the kingdom of God. And so, you know, we're transformed, it says in the Bible, by the renewing of our minds. So this is very important. And then chapter 6 introduces us to the order of the family and the whole armor of God. And so that's what I'm going to do for this particular one. I'm going to read Ephesians 6. It shows some graphics here from 10, verse 10 to verse 18 on the whole armor of God. "Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. Put on the whole armor of God, that you might be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand. And so we see by these few verses from verse 6-10, Ephesians 2:13, that we need to have our renewed mind and transformed in the renewing of our mind, because our fight is against belief systems that we can't see, rulers of the darkness, against spiritual wickedness in high places, etc. Verse 14, stand therefore, having your loins girt about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith you shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. And take this helmet of salvation, and the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. Praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching thereunto, with all perseverance and supplications with all saints. And I'll finish here with this reference to Matthew 18:20, for where two or three come together in my name, I am there with them. As well, I will finish with Ephesians 19:20. And for me, that utterance may be given unto me, that I may open my mouth boldly to make known the mystery of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in chains or bonds, and that therein I may speak boldly as I ought to speak. And that's our wonderful Saint Paul. Thank God for him. He gave his life for the gospel that we might have it. God bless you.